A brave decision. That's how financial giant ING Bank described the Philippine Central Bank's move to cut interest rates. It also believes it won't be the last. ING notes the Philippines' higher than expected inflation print may have made the rate cut questionable, but it expects the upcoming inflation data to vindicate the Banco Central's decision. It now pegs the BSP's terminal policy rate at around 4.5% to 5%. That's up to 175 basis points lower than its rate hike Thursday. This is as it sees Philippine inflation stabilizing at around 3.5% next year. Now, here are some local corporate headlines. ABS-CBN Corporation narrows its net loss in the first half of 2024. The parent firm of this news network saw losses down by 5% to 2.12 billion pesos. Consolidated revenues stood at 7.8 billion, backed in part by higher advertising revenue. ABS-CBN says it continues to explore and pursue business opportunities with local and foreign entities to ensure maximum exposure and monetization of its content assets. Meanwhile, Double Dragon's first half bottom line climbs 4% to 1.6 billion pesos. The Injapsia-led firm cites an 11% growth in revenue to 4.4 billion pesos. Its total assets grew to 191 billion pesos, while total equity rose to 95.1 billion. Now, this puts Double Dragon on track to exceed 100 billion in total equity. As for Frutas Holdings, its first half net income jumps to 65 million pesos from last year's 44 million. Revenues also higher as Frutas continues to add more brands to its F&B portfolio. And finally, GT Capital nets 13.8 billion pesos in the first semester, higher by 5% year on year. This was brought by record high profit from Metrobank and improved retail vehicle sales from Toyota Motor Philippines. U.S. President Joe Biden touts the effectiveness of his economic policies. Government data show the U.S. inflation rate dropped below 3% in July for the first time in 3 years. Now, this opens the door wider for the Federal Reserve to cut interest rates next month. An ecstatic Biden told digital content creators gathered in the White House Wednesday he always knew the U.S. economy will see a soft landing. That's when the Fed is able to raise rates to curb inflation without causing a recession.
Yes, yes, yes. I told you we're going to have a soft landing. We're going to have a soft landing. My policies are working. Start right in that way, okay?
Global jet fuel demand seemed to soften as a slowdown in consumer spending impacts travel budgets. Data from Goldman Sachs show global jet fuel demand averaged about 7.49 million barrels per day as of the end of July. While that's an increase of nearly 500,000 compared to the same period last year, the bank says demand will need to rise more rapidly in the coming months to meet its growth forecast of 600,000 barrels per day for the year. But this seems unlikely, as Goldman Sachs estimates indicate demand growth from August through October will likely be only around 400,000 BPD. Global oil demand has not met expectations in the first half of 2024 due to weaker than expected consumption in the U.S. and China, the two largest oil markets. Jet fuel makes up about 7% of global oil demand and was widely expected to be a pillar of growth this year. North Korea will reportedly resume international tourism to its northeastern city of Samjeon in December. Several China-based tour agencies made that announcement, adding that opening the border to the rest of the country could happen as well. North Korea has not been fully open to international tourists since 2020 due to the COVID pandemic. The northeastern city of Samjeon is near Mount Paektu, the supposed holy mountain where North Korean leader Kim Jong-un's family claims its roots.